Welcome back, everybody, to another Dicon Dissectional production hosted by Deathstroke9. Today we are going to be reacting to Norman Greenbaum, Spirit in the Sky. Now, this was not, this has not been very heavily requested, but I said that I was going to go through, like, the top comments on my video, "This is so sick," I think was the name of the video. And I was just looking to see what the top comments were and what the suggestions in those comments were. And this was one of the top ones. So I went and looked up the song, and it has about 50 million views on YouTube. So yeah, I'm excited to check this out. I don't think I've heard it. Yeah. So thank you so much for joining me. If you're new to the channel, hi, my name's Daniel, and here we react to music and then some other stuff, and I try to figure out what the music and the lyrics mean to me personally. If that sounds interesting to you, consider subscribing. But yeah, let me know if there's any other songs by this artist that you'd like me to check out, and thank you so much for requesting this. Here we go. Norman Greenbaum, Spirit in the Sky. 3, 2, 1. Okay. That main, like, I don't know what to call it, the riff, I guess, the main driving force of the song with the guitar, that's super distorted and kind of going do 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 do, that that's really cool. I feel like, so are there, there's probably a bunch of songs that use that general style of, I guess, riff, right? It's, that sounds familiar. That sounds like something I've heard in multiple songs in the past. And yeah, so far the song is like a, it feels, it's a rocking song. It's a jammy song. And it's, so is he talking about, like, going to heaven? Is that what the spirit in the sky, does he mean, like, God? I'm not certain. Let's continue. Probably. Love the guitar. Prepare yourself, you know it's a must. Gonna have a friend in Jesus. Yeah, there you go. So you know that when you die, he's gonna recommend you to the spirit in the sky. He's gonna recommend you to the spirit in the sky. That's where you're gonna go when you die. When you die and you lay it to rest, you're gonna go to the place that's the best. Set it up, let's go. That guitar bit sounded like almost like a Tony Iommi riff or tone to the guitar. Ironic. Never been a sinner, I never sinned. I got a friend in Jesus. we're fading out. Dang it. All right. Well, I quite enjoyed that. It was fun. The solo was awesome. Yeah, this feels like a great rock song. Let's see. Oh my. My mother had this song played at her funeral when they carried... I'm reading a comment, by the way. When they carried her casket out. It was epic. Oh, okay. Interesting. My 66-year-old father died on February 16th, 2021 from COVID. He loved this song, so I'm adding it to his online memorial site. Love you, Dad. Miss you like crazy. That guitar distortion is perfect. Never gets old. Yeah, it was super heavy. Like, it felt almost... When I first started to hear it, it sounded almost out of place within the context of the rest of the song. Then it kind of blended in really well, so it worked perfectly. But, yeah. So... if all Christian songs were like this, I would go to church more often. Yeah, Christian music right now sucks really bad. It's crazy. Like, I remember, actually, I'll bring that up another time. But let's take a look at the lyrics. Thank you so much for joining me. Let's see. Set to be a religious rock song. Jewish, always Jewish, Norman Greenbaum. Used Jesus, thinking that it would be more marketable this way, and he was right. In his own words, I'm just some Jewish musician who really dug gospel music. I decided there was a larger gospel market out there than a Jehovah one, more of a Jesus one. The singer's take on the song, it appeals to one's inner self and the need for redemption. Plus, heck, who wants to go to hell? Yeah. Yep. Not only is this a classic case of a one-hit wonder, it was re-released by another one-hit wonder, Doctor and the Medics. In both cases, the song topped the charts in the UK. A third version, a tongue-in-cheek studio recording in 2003 by Gareth Gates and the Kumars, also topped the charts, also in the UK. That's crazy. All right. Norman Greenbaum, former member of the psychedelic jug band Dr. West's Medicine Show and Junk Band, was watching a performance by country and gospel singer Porter Wagoner singing a stirring song about forgiveness and redemption. With no experience or relation to the genre, he decided immediately that he could write a gospel song. I thought, yeah, I could do that, knowing nothing about gospel music, he remembers. So I sat down, wrote my own gospel song. It came easy, and I wrote the words in about 15 minutes. Even though Mr. Greenbaum no longer has the publishing rights to this song, he still receives a check for at least $10,000 every time it is licensed for a movie or ad, which is very often. He also has a website where he sells hats, t-shirts, CDs, mouse pads, and the like. I get emails from 9 and 10-year-old kids who say it's their favorite song. I've gotten letters from funeral directors telling me it's their second most requested song to play in memorial services next to Danny Boy. Wow. Off the album Spirit in the Sky. So he's a one-hit wonder, but there's a whole album of music here. I never liked that. I mean, I guess it sometimes it makes sense. I just don't really like it because it feels like it is almost degrading to the artist, any artist, to call them a one-hit wonder specifically. Like, they only ever had one song that was, you know, I don't know. Just not a thing that I really like. Anyway, thank you so much for joining me. It was a great song. I will see you guys soon. And Deathstroke 9, out. We are Legion.